here in this circuit we are having x1 and x2, so that can be identified as inputs. And here we are having capital Y, therefore this one is next state, and here we are having small y, present state. Okay, so that can be given from the output excitation capital Y to the feedback of that next state capital Y. Okay, so first we need to go for the transition table. Okay, so here simply we are having only one output excitation or next state, therefore there is no need to go for map for each states. Okay, so here we can directly go for the transition table. Okay, so for the transition table, this expression should be in sum of product form. Okay, to make that expression in sum of product form, so here what I am doing is, first I am expanding it, capital Y is equal to x1 y the whole bar into x2. So here what I am doing, first I am applying the De Morgan's law. Okay, so here I will get x1 bar plus y bar into x2. Okay, now if I expand it, x1 bar x2 plus y bar x2. Okay, so now the expression is in SOP form. Okay, sum of product form. Now we can go for the transition table. So here we are having two inputs, x1 and x2, so it should be in horizontal axis, and I am having only one excitation, therefore it should be in vertical axis. Okay, so here y, x1, x2, here the possibilities are 2, 0 and 1, here 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So we can go for the inverse K map. So here we won't have Y value, that means Y is 0, 1 change, which covers 2 rows, and here x1 bar x2, that means 0, 1. Okay, so which covers these two columns. Okay, if you want you can check it. Okay, if you group this value, we will get the value as x1 bar x2. Then we are having the second one as y bar x2, that means here y bar means which select this row, and x2 means here x2 is common for these two values. Okay, so here the intersection area, this column and this column, and here we'll get the value as 1, 1. Remaining places we need to mark it as 0, 0, 0. Okay, now we need to go for the stable state. So here present state and next states are same for stable state. So here stable 1, here also we are having the stable state, here we are having the present state as 1, therefore here I will have the stable state. Okay, now we need to go for checking the column wise. Okay, for stability of the circuit. Okay, so here first column we are having one stable state, the second column we are having one stable state, third column we are not having any stable state. Okay, therefore here y I is not equal to capital Y I. Okay, therefore this circuit is unstable, because in a column we are not having any stable state. Okay, so here I will explain the condition. Okay, so just consider a input condition 1, 1, and if the present state is equal to 0, means here we are having the next state as 1. Okay, it's not a stable state. Okay, so after some times what happens is this 1 will be the present state, and we are having the input as 1, 1, therefore what happens, which will move to the next state as 0. Okay, after that what happens, After some time, this 0 will be the present state, and for the input condition 1, 1, here it goes to the state 1. Okay, next state is 1. So here, from here it toggles to this value. From here, again it's go back to the previous value, okay, which won't get stabilized, okay, which makes this system unstable.